who I'm talking to.
All right, my name's John Troy. I work for On The Go Devices.
Do you have a ham license?
I sure do. KI4YUM.
Yankee
United.
YUM.
YUM.
All right. So what is a Remote Shack?
Remote Shack is a very inexpensive way that allows you to gain control of your system remotely from anywhere around the world, all from your cell phone or the internet.
This would be an HF rig for HF operating?
HF, ICOM, Yaesu, Kenwood, Flex, you name it, we interface to it. One black box solution allows you to gain access to your radio wherever you are.
And what do you need on either end to be able to do this, and how much can you do?
You can do almost every function in the radio, all from any cell phone. It does not have to be a smartphone. And you can do it to just about all the radio manufacturers that I mentioned. With one black box located, the remote check here that you see at the location that needs to be remoted.
See, now something went by me a little bit too fast. I was so much expecting you to say I needed a PC or a Mac or, you know, so laptop or whatever. You said cell phone.
Right. You don't need a PC. You do not need the internet. You do not need know how to program, and you will not be soldering. The remote shack comes, everything you get comes all as one package. You get the cable kit already done up for your particular radio, okay? And you get the everything in one unit, ready to go, plug and play solution. You're on the air remotely, 2.5 minutes.
So you can obviously talk and listen.
You can talk, you can receive, you can change frequencies, scan the band, change your antennas, turn on and off remote relays. So the possibilities are pretty much what you want to come up with.
So on the remote end, what is my manipulation? Just different touch tone codes?
In the field, your client side, you can use a iPhone, iPad, a regular phone, with any phone that you want, a desk phone. It's all DTMF controlled. So you can run a Droid phone running Skype. You can run an iPhone running Skype. You can run an iPad running Skype. So you can just anything that'll generate a DTMF tone, you can access the unit with.
All right. So things are going to be more limited than Remote Shack software, where you're getting metering and readouts and stuff back. You're not getting stuff back except sound.
Yes, you're getting full audio back responses from requests made from in the field. So if you want to get frequency back, that's a specific command, and it's going to give you frequency as far as what the radio is doing.
So it sounds like this would be good for remoting in to do something in particular, maybe not just casual operating tuning the band, but if you've got a net or something.
Full tunes the band?
You can.
No, you can do all functions that the radio can do.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of how pleasant that's going to be from that kind of an interface.
Well, it's our users. It's pretty pleasant to be able to flip out your cell phone while you're sitting waiting for a plane and be able to go on the air and by as fast as you can make a phone call. So as fast as you can make a phone call, this is going to answer and put you on the air. So you don't need any other equipment. You don't need, you don't need an additional radio. You don't need a speaker. All you need remotely is your cell phone. And this microphone on your cell phone becomes your microphone on your rig. And this speaker here coming out your earpiece is what you'll be hearing over the air.
Do you have some security access code to get it started?
Right, absolutely. If you like, I'll give you a demo of the product.
Let's see how much we can do here.
So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to give I'm using a cordless phone, but it can be a cell phone, of course, a desk phone, a Skype call. It doesn't really matter. So let's go ahead. We'll bring it up. As soon as we do, we'll get a password request. Enter in our password, just like a voicemail system.
Welcome. General.
Once we successfully enter the passcode, our radio will turn on for us automatically and tell us our frequency.
3 USB.
From here, we can scan the band, recall or set memories. I'll go ahead and scan up. Radio's going to scan. All of a sudden, we hear a station in. We hit the stop, and then we fine-tune that station in. Once we got the station right on, if we want, we can store them in memory, just like we would if we were sitting in front of the radio. From here, we can switch antennas, bring up a signal level. So let's go to antenna 1.
Antenna 1.
Or antenna 2.
antenna two.
In addition, we can rotate the beam. You got to be able to do that while you're driving down the road, right?
Of course.
Absolutely. So let's go ahead and do it. He's in Minnesota, so let's swing it around to 100, bearing 100. It repeats the bearing to me to verify the command that I entered, and then it's going to fire up the beam and rotate.
Okay, so, and your signs up there are simulating our antenna, and they are indeed rotating.
Yes, exactly. So that's beam rotation. From there, we also have included in the remote shack is one relay that allows you to, you can turn it on and off however you like. That's demonstrated by our blue light over here. Okay, that's our auxiliary one. You can usually use that. Guys use it to turn on and off an amplifier. Okay, we can also, let's see here. If we go to menu number 3, we can then apply any filter that we want. Okay?
So you've got just about every control available in the radio. Are there radios that have missing pieces, or have you been able to tap into everything?
We have a locked command set that are available on most radios that we have picked long before we made the design on the unit. And all of those units, all of those commands are control, are all the same for all the radios. Okay, so the nice thing about the unit is if you have a TS2000 and your another friend has a FTDX 5000 or 9000, the codes are the same to operate either radio.
All right, and how do you remember all that stuff?
Well, we have a cheat sheet that we supply with the unit, okay, that you can either put this on your phone in the digital form, or you can have the cheat sheet in your back pocket, and it has every command you would ever need right here.
And I suppose you could become a pro at it and memorize all that
stuff. Week. It's a very simple format. Receive is the first menu. Once you're sitting in front of the radio, it's the same. As soon as you dial in, you're in receive. Then your next one is select which antenna you want. Next menu is what filter you want to apply. And then finally, QSO, which is actually keying up the radio.
All right. Now, do you have to share a phone line with the rest of the household or whatever?
Well, with the price of phone lines today, you can get a digital line from Vonage, Magic Jack. It doesn't matter. All we need is an RJ11 jack that rings, pretty much. And that's only one port. The other port we have on the unit is specially designed for Skype and a computer.
Okay, so you could Skype into it as well.
That's right. You can actually do either one for redundancy. You see, with remote-based technologies, redundancy is very important. If you don't have redundancy and your internet goes down or something happens, that's a problem because obviously you don't want to be off the air when you're traveling. The remote shack gives you two ports, one a regular telephone line and then the other being a VoIP or Skype input.
You got some kind of a fail-safe if you've been on the air, maybe transmitting, and suddenly your access is gone.
Absolutely. Your cell phone can drop off. Within 3 minutes, the whole system shuts down. As you heard just there a moment, it's asking me, am I still there? Because we've been talking for exactly 2.5 minutes. That's how I know this. So after 30 seconds, this whole system is going to shut down in front of us.
Okay, so this is very intriguing. If somebody wants to know more about it, how do they find you?
RemoteShack.com.
That sounds pretty easy.
Yep.
And ballpark, what are we looking at spending?
$479 for the unit, $69.95 for the cable kit that is handmade and custom designed for your particular radio.
Goodbye. And, of course, the optional accessories.
Yeah, the optional accessories include an interface for control via cordless phone. So instead of plugging in a regular landline, you can plug in our cordless phone interface, which will allow you just to operate via the pool, and you just plug in a headset into your cordless phone, and you're on the air just as well, as opposed to being on the air with the cellular. In addition, we have an 8-relay control card, which allows you to turn on 8 different things that you want to turn on and off at home, whether that be a disconnect for lightning, or whether that be a connect for an antenna switch, or what have you.
Okay, so a single relay comes with it,
right,
and the option to expand to 8.
That's correct.
Or to 9, I guess.
That's correct. And they're all, of course, under DTMF control. Right. In addition to that, that also has a remote control on it, which allows you to set those 8 switches manually, all with the RF remote control. So you can put the RF remote control at your bench and still have a way to turn on the remote switches right from the workbench. In addition, we have an 8 antenna controller, which is available, so you can select up to 8 different antennas. That has a full PL259 in and out, single in, 8 antenna IO.
You never have to go home again.
No, yes. You just, all you need to do is enter it in and you got it. With full voice control capability, of course.
All right. Well, it seems like quite an awesome system. Once again, give me the price point for the base unit and then maybe the accessories a little bit.
Right. Okay. Well, right now the price point on the unit itself is $479 and with the cable kit it's $69.95. If you want to do the cordless phone interface, that's going to be $129. For just a simple cordless phone interface. If you want an automatic cordless phone interface, which allows both telco use and a cordless phone interface, it's $189. All additional accessories that we've explored here, check on our website, RemoteShack.com, and they're all listed.
Okay, so it's not dirt cheap, but it you got good value for the money.
Actually, the way the way I think about it, okay, if you've spent several thousand dollars on your system, okay, if it's $3,000 for your tower and another $1,000 for the antenna, $12,000 maybe for a radio, it's $500 to get it on your side of your hip, okay, anywhere you are in the world. So for us, it's. It's really reasonable cost from that perspective.
I think you made a good point.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you. Thanks for coming.